All right, the creme de la creme, as our very own Brian Lawton called him.
I didn't know Brian Lawton spoke French.
A little bit.
Who knew that? Who knew that?
We find a lot of things out about Lawton. But we're going to find a whole lot more about Mark Stone and his fit now in Vegas as he joins us on his off day on the phone right now. Mark, congratulations on the fit so far and the contract extension there as a Golden Knight. Almost 2 weeks now since your move from Ottawa to Vegas. How's life been, both on and off the ice for you?
Oh, it's been awesome so far. There's a bit of an adjustment, not just moving to a different team, but moving to a different style city. But everything here is first class. It's been unbelievable so far.
Mark, it's Dave Reed here. Congratulations on the new contract and the move to Vegas. Now, you're coming from a team that the playoffs weren't in the picture this year to a team that are focused on the playoffs. Since you've been there, this team really seems to have refocused. Do you feel, you weren't there in the past, but do you feel that there's a real focus to get past where this team went last year in the Stanley Cup final?
Yeah, I mean, right when I got here, I think they're going through a bit of a tough stretch. And from the second I walked in that locker room, the guys were focused on winning hockey games and trying to make sure that we can increase our spot in the standings. And the five games that I've played, the team that we have has the ability to take over and dominate games.
Mark, having come over, I think you're five games into, kind of your tenure as a Vegas Golden Knight. Probably not your first test of Pacific Division hockey, but a pretty scrappy contest versus the Flames last night. You guys come out on top. Your impressions of the Pacific Division rivalry so far? What's life like in the Pacific?
It's definitely different. The Western Conference is a little different hockey. But, that game last night was awesome. It was so much fun to be a part of. We got some timely goals. We got some timely saves. And the guys are sticking up for each other throughout the entire night. You're kind of seeing that as I, grow with this team. You kind of see that these guys really care about one another, and I'm so excited to be a part of that.
Speaking of impressions, this is the first time we've had a chance to chat with you since the deadline acquisition. I got to ask you about the arrival at McCarran International Airport there in Vegas. Not everybody who flies into that town gets that kind of reception. Did you know that was coming? And if you didn't, what were your expectations and your first impressions of seeing the hoopla that they rolled out for you?
Well, I think you can tell by my hair and my face, I was not ready to be on camera. So, I was completely surprised, completely shocked. And I was really impressive. So many people from the staff of the Knights was there to welcome me, which, I wasn't expecting. I was kind of just expecting a driver to be there to pick me up. So, for them to do that for me was awesome. I was excited to get into Vegas.
Hey, Mark, I like what Max Pacioretty, your new linemate, talked about when you came into the first scrum. He thought he was going to put his hands up to protect himself. This is your first move to a different team, different organization, some new teammates. How has that been, and how is it playing with Max Pacioretty on your side? Because you guys were in a pretty heated rivalry for years with Ottawa and Montreal.
Yeah, for sure. I mean, we went through two playoff series against each other, play each other four times, and those games are always so physical, so scrappy. So, your life can change so quickly, and for me, it changed in 20 minutes with the trade. So, I was excited. I mean, and right when I walked in the locker room, I saw that he was going to be playing left wing with me and Skastny. It was kind of shocking. It kind of blink twice to actually believe that you were on a team with Max Pacioretty after all the battles you went through. But I think everybody says it in hockey. There's so many good people in hockey. No matter how fierce the battles are on the ice, mostly every guy who plays in the National Hockey League is a good person.
You know, Mark, you mentioned life in the West, and I'm a player as well that kind of spent a little time in the East, spent a little time in the West. You almost get a sense, you know, the contrast can be so sharp that it's almost like playing in a different league. Your experience so far, what are some of the, you know, just in a quick sense, what are some of the differences between life out East, life out West, just in terms of the style of play, the travel?
Yeah, I mean, the travel is definitely one thing. We've only had one road game since I've been here, and it was just a quick trip to Anaheim. But, you know, tomorrow we're heading out to Vancouver. It's a 2 or 3 hour flight, which is a lot different for me. But, you know, it just takes a little bit of time. You know, I think right now the way the West is so clogged up, there's still so many teams that can get into the playoff picture that games are so tight, whereas I think maybe in the East, I was on one of those teams that was bottom of the standings. The games don't mean as much. I think right now, the way the West is shaping up, these games, they mean so much. Every game, you know, can make or break somebody's season. So there's been some tight games since I've been here.
Yeah, and after what we saw last night, there's a lot of us out there rooting for a first-round matchup between you guys and the Flames and Evander Holyfield, a.k.a. Marc-Andre Fleury. Mark, we won't keep you any longer. Appreciate the time on your off day. Good luck the rest of the season.
No problem, guys. Thank you.